Welcome to Gateway. This is not really episode 2, this is kind of a bonus episode where I'm going to read out what is happening in your dataman, because that was the last thing we got. This will end up at the end of the playlist because this does nothing for the plot at all. It is simply there so that you understand how to play the game. So, read dataman. This looks a lot like the message system that we had before. O turns off, 1 turns 3 takes you into further menus. As you can see on the left, there is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Pressing the corresponding number takes you into about that thing. So the first heading is we have off, and we've got information about gateway. I'm going to do that first. I'm going to do ship handling notes, and I'm going to do a corporation record where you won't see anything in particular. But anyway, off we go. So, and yeah, this is like a sub menu, and if you go back, you'd go back to the main menu. So we're going to start with Gateway Station. Gateway is a large abandoned alien artifact circling the sun near the orbit of Venus. Gateway was built over 500,000 years ago by vanished aliens commonly known as the Hechi. The name Gateway comes from the 1,000 operational faster-than-light airships that were found aboard the derelict station. To humankind, which does not possess the secret of FTL travel, Gateway and its ships hold the bright promise of important new technology, interstellar exploration, and potentially even contact with new civilizations. So if we bail out of here, we're going to go O, and it's going to take us to the last menu that we saw. I kind of wish that they had a forward and backward here, but oh well. Gateway Corporation. Gateway is unique in the history of humanity, and it was quickly realized that it was too valuable a resource to be given to any one government. A multinational corporation, known as Gateway Enterprises, often referred to as the Corporation, was established to occupy Gateway and exploit the technology of the Hechi. The corporation manages Gateway Station and administers an aggressive exploration program using the alien starships and encourages commercial development of Hechi technology. The corporation is a vast enterprise employing tens of thousands of the world's best and brightest people. Revenues for last fiscal year exceed $3.7 trillion in adjusted dollars. Okay. Gateway Prospectors. The primary means of exploiting Gateway and the Hechi starships is through prospecting. Gateway Prospectors are human volunteers who ride the alien ships in the hope that they will visit other worlds and bring back alien machines, tools, and other potentially useful items. Because the guidance systems of the Hechi starships are beyond the understanding of human scientists, the ships are sent to destinations that are unknown. The corporation rewards successful prospectors with royalties on their discoveries. For obvious reasons, prospecting missions carry an extraordinary degree of risk. 80% of missions return with little or nothing. 5% produce substantial returns for the prospector involved, and 15% don't come back at all. Alright. So we got the four major powers. Four countries own all the voting stock in Gateway Enterprises: Brazil, Japan, the United States of America, and the United States of Europe. The United States of Europe is basically the EU, I imagine. Each of these countries provides capital to the corporation and reaps benefit from the exploitation of Hechi technology. The four major powers provide for protection of Gateway through the cabinet, the Combined Sentinel Force, a multinational organization that is comprised of Brazilian, Japanese, US, and European military units. These units are stationed in and around corporation facilities on Earth and in space. Gateway's defenses include four military interplanetary cruisers, the USS Mayaguez, I think I said that right, the RB Brasilia, the Avenging Sun, and the Joint Command and Data Detachments of Military Police and Navy personnel from each of the four countries. Getting around Level Dog. Level Dog is the center of the station, both physically and administratively. On Level Dog, you will find Hechi Town, the large cavern that houses the corporation administrative section, barracks, and the Blue Hell Bar. from Heechee Town. Corridor D4 leads to Central Park, the hydroponics facility, and corridor D6 leads to the Gateway Museum. A drop shaft in D4 will take you up or down. Okay, so let's talk about Level Tanya. If you take the drop shaft down to Level Tanya, you will find yourself in corridor T6. Immediately to the west will be conference room T20. To the north is corridor T5, which leads to the armory. To the south is corridor T7, which has entrances to the ship hangars and conference room T52. You must be registered as flight crew and be in possession of a blue badge in order to get beyond the gate in the ship hangar entrance. Generally, the only time you will need to go into the hangar is when you are about to embark on a prospecting mission. We need to look at using your PB Comset. Your PB Comset is a terminal link into the computer and communication systems aboard Gateway Station. Comsets are located in your quarters and in many of the common areas on Gateway. You can use the PB Comset to call other PB users, play recorded message from other callers, access news and current events at networks from Earth, access to the Gateway Bulletin Board, and check on your account balance. The bulletin board is a place where prospectors, corporation employees, and others leave useful information, messages, advertisements, and sometimes even poetry and stories. The bulletin board is the best way to get to put a finger on the pulse of life on Gateway. Okay. 8. Your proctor. Your proctor is the person who gave you this personal information system. He or she is a fellow prospector who has been assigned to take care of you for the first day on Gateway Station. He or she will explain life on the station and assist you in settling in. You can expect your proctor to treat you to a drink in the Blue Hell Bar as the final step in your initiation. It is customary to buy him or her at least one drink as well. Who knows? You might become friends. I love that. That's probably the most sarcastic thing this particular manual says. The VR terminal. VR, of course, being virtual reality. On the second floor of the corporation office block of Liberal Dog, you will find a virtual reality terminal. The system is a prototype and has been programmed with 3 experimental virtual realities. 2 of these VRs are available for general use. Before you decide to use the VR terminal, you should note that virtual reality can be a very intense experience. Kinesthetic effects and input for all 5 of your senses will be fed directly to your brain. The virtual reality will seem as real to you as any other experience you have had in your life. Gateway Enterprises assumes no responsibility for mental or emotional trauma. Thanks, Gateway. You guys are awesome. Actually, the company, I should say. So we're going to bail back out, and then we're going to go into ship handling notes. The cabin of a Heechee starship, the ship controls, setting course. Departing Gateway, exploring your destination, landing on the surface of a planet, your spacesuit returning to orbit, and returning to Gateway. So we're going to start off with number 1, which is the cabin of a Heechee starship. The cabin of ships found on Gateway are remarkably similar. The main features of the inside of the ship include the seats, the control panel, and a bunch of instrumentation and machinery that scientists know very little about. I like how they're also very forthright about this. They're aware that they don't actually know what's going on yet, and they're just sending you on basically a lottery, and they hope that you'll come back with something useful. To access the control panel, sit in the seat. The ship controls. The configuration of the control panel is simple to understand. The top half is original Heechee equipment, including the course selection mechanism, the FDL controls, and the lander controls. The FDL controls consist of 2 buttons, labeled using sticky tape as go and return. Now, that seems cheap to me. I'm not sure why they would use sticky tape, but there you go. That activate the ship's faster-than-light propulsion system. The lander controls in the upper right-hand of the panel, labeled as orbit and land, activate the hydrogen-oxygen maneuvering rockets used for landing and taking off from planets. The bottom half of the control panel is supplied by the corporation. Corporation scientists have added a parasitic sensor array that taps into Heechee systems. On the corporation panel, you will find a display screen with these 3 buttons. code, info, and view. Now, this also puzzles me. They don't really understand Hichi science, but somehow they've managed to add their own panel to the Hichi starships. Oh well. We will suspend disbelief, because that is what we're here for. Setting a course. To set a course, follow these simple instructions. 1. Press the code button on the lower control panel to get a list of available course codes. 2. Use the up arrow and down arrow buttons as the course, on the course selection mechanisms located in the upper left hand corner of the control panel to set a course. Make sure that the Hichi characters in the four little windows exactly match the character shown on the display screen for the course code you want to set. If they match exactly, you will successfully enter the course into the Hichi ship. Warning: do not attempt to enter a new course at any point during a mission. You are committed once you have engaged FTL drive. You must return to Gateway before the ship will successfully accept a new course. I am not sure why that is, but I assume it's just so that, in Hichi terms, you could get there and back without incident. Departing Gateway. Once you have set a course, you are ready to depart from Gateway. While this decision is to engage the FTL propulsion system is momentous, the act is quite simple. Press the glowing yellow button marked Go, and you will be on your way. Note that the button will not be lit unless the ship is ready to go. You cannot engage the FTL drive on the surface of a planet. You must lift off and go into orbit using the chemical rockets. See returning to Gateway. If you have successfully activated the drive, you will experience some mild physical discomfort as the ship goes into tower space. Again, I think that's all just fail-safe-y. So if you're on a planet and you're digging around, you can't just send the planet back if your mission is going to fail. Exploring your destination. When your ship arrives at whatever destination was programmed into it, you are ready to begin your exploration. The first thing to do is a sensor sweep. This will be done automatically for you when you press the info button on the lower part of the control panel. The results of the scan will appear on the display screen. You can get an external camera view of your destination using the view button. The live picture will appear on the display screen. If you look at the lander controls in the upper right hand corner of the screen, you may see that the land button has lit up. If so, this is an indication that the Hichi systems are ready to guide your ship in for a landing on whatever planet or object may be in immediate vicinity. If the land button is not lit, then there is no place to land and you should return to Gateway. Landing on the surface of a planet. If you're in orbit around a planet and the land button on the landing control... Oh, wait, we just read this. Sorry. Yes. No? No, actually, we haven't. You have the option of landing on the surface of the planet. You accomplish this by pressing the land button, which activates an automatic control system that takes over the ship. The control system will steer the ship through the atmospheric entry, search for a suitable landing site near any concentrations of Hichi metal, and touch down on a selected landing site. Once you're on the surface, you can exit the ship and explore your surroundings. See your spacesuit. I like how now they're telling you to see your spacesuit, but you can't go immediately to that from here. So your spacesuit. You must wear your spacesuit when exploring hostile environments. The sensor scan you made from orbit or from the surface of the planet will tell you if the environment on the surface of a planet is hostile or not. Now, by hostile, I assume they mean whether or not it has breathable air, as well as whether or not there are hostile people on there, but I'm not sure. Returning to orbit. Once you have finished your exploration of a planet's surface, you are ready to return to orbit. You cannot activate the FTL drive while you are physically on the surface, and so you cannot return to Gateway until you have used the chemical rockets to leave the planet. To depart, simply press the orbit button in the upper right-hand corner of the ship's panel, and the chemical rockets will kick in and lift you into orbit. To return to Gateway from orbit or from a position in interstellar or interplanetary space. Ooh, sorry. Simply press the return button under the FTL sticky tape label. Okay, and that is about it. If you look at corporation record, you'll see nothing here because you haven't done anything. So there we go. And off we go. Right, so that was the dataman. On Friday, we will pick up the game from where we left off and we will start playing again. For those people watching this after the fact and watching this as a bonus episode, thank you for watching it because it is out of the way. I will see you all shortly, I'll see you all on Friday, and for everyone else watching this after the fact, thank you so much for watching Gateway, if you did. I appreciate it. Have a great evening, folks, and goodbye.